chestnuts roasting on an open fire, Jack Frost nipping at your nose.
In 1919, Nathaniel Adams Coles was born in Montgomery, Alabama, to Edward James Coles, a Baptist minister, and Perlina Adams Coles. Nat began playing the piano at age 4, displaying an early talent for music. The Coles family moved to Chicago's Bronzeville neighborhood, a hub of African-American culture and music. Nat dropped out of high school to pursue music full-time. He formed the Royal Dukes with his brother Eddie, performing at local venues. Nat changed his name to Nat King Cole, adopting the moniker King, after the nursery rhyme in which Old King Cole was a merry old soul. The Nat King Cole Trio was formed with Oscar Moore on guitar and Wesley Prince on double bass. The Nat King Cole Trio began performing at the Swanee Inn in Chicago, gaining popularity for their innovative jazz sound. The trio recorded their first tracks for Decca Records, including Honey Hush and Easy Listening Blues.
She's that gal from New Orleans. They all sigh when she passes by, when she says honey hush.
The Nat King Cole Trio released their first album, The King Cole Trio, featuring tracks like Sweet Lorraine and Embraceable You.
I'm as happy as a baby boy.
Nat King Cole recorded Straighten Up and Fly Right, a breakout hit that reaches number one on the R&B charts. The Nat King Cole Trio recorded the Christmas song, Chestnuts Roasting on an Open Fire, which became a perennial holiday favorite. Nat King Cole made his acting debut in the film Killer Diller, showcasing his musical talents on screen.
I never lost my heart while stealing a glance, taking a chance, trying romance, but when your eyes hang out that danger sign, ooh, kick-a-rooney. But I just can't get my words to hypnotize.
The trio toured internationally, gaining fans in Europe and beyond.
You bet you it gets me. And yet, every time I...
Mona Lisa. Cole's rendition of Mona Lisa became a massive crossover success, topping both the pop and R&B charts.
Unforgettable.
Cole released Unforgettable, an album featuring the title track and other classics. Nat King Cole scored another major hit with Smile, featuring lyrics by Charlie Chaplin.
Come shining through for you. Light up your face. A blossom fell from off a tree.
He recorded A Blossom Fell, another chart-topping hit, showcasing his enduring appeal.
You turn to me.
The Nat King Cole Show.
He became the first African American to host his own radio show, The Nat King Cole Show, on NBC.
And there you are, ladies and gentlemen, here are our guests for tonight.
And you know, Nat, this week, our program is really going to be different.
I hope so, Tony. You know, we always try.
Well, they say that the reason...
Nat King Cole was attacked on stage by white supremacists during a performance in Birmingham, Alabama, highlighting the ongoing racial tensions in the United States.
Well, I mean, if that was the case, then I'm the wrong guy.
You're not rock and roll.
I don't think so. I think if you heard me before, I'm sure you wouldn't ask me that if you heard me before. What do you know what rock and roll is?
What were you singing when those men attacked you?
The great Nat King Cole.
Despite critical acclaim, the Nat King Cole Show was canceled due to lack of sponsorship, a blow to Cole's television career.
For me, little girl, you're as sweet as can be, just a glance at
St. Louis woman.
He released St. Louis Blues, a film adaptation of the W.C. Handy opera, in which he stars as Handy.
Who's that man around by her apron string?
Nat King Cole made history as the first African American to win a Grammy Award, earning Best Performance by a Male Pop Vocalist for Midnight Flyer.
Midnight Flyer.
Found when I came to your country.
Cole toured the world, performing in Europe, Asia, and Africa, spreading his musical influence globally.
So, I hope you don't mind if I sort of read the words off the music, okay?
The perfume in the air, it's all there.
He continued to tour and record, maintaining his status as one of the preeminent voices in popular music.
This is it.
It's a beautiful.
Cole released Those Lazy Hazy Crazy Days of Summer, a cheerful album featuring the title track and other seasonal favorites. Nat King Cole was diagnosed with lung cancer, attributed to his heavy smoking habit.
I fell in love.
Despite his declining health, he continued to perform and record, displaying remarkable resilience in the face of adversity.
With my fair lady.
On February 15, 1965, Nat King Cole passed away at the age of 46, leaving behind a legacy of timeless music and unparalleled artistry.
L is for the way you look.
His final album, Love, was released posthumously, featuring the iconic title track and other beloved classics.
One I see. V is very, very extraordinary. When I fall in love.
Cole's influence on the world of music endures, inspiring future generations of artists and leaving an indelible mark on the history of jazz and popular music.
Or I'll never fall in love.
Thank you.